I'm EA Draffan. I'm a research fellow at the University of Southampton. I trained as a speech and language therapist, but have worked in many different fields related to communication mostly, and with students who have disabilities. ATbar is a very small browser-based toolbar that's rather like a bookmark that you can add to any browser. It came out of a project called Lexdis, which was about persuading students to participate and share their strategies on how they use technology. These were initially disabled students at the University of Southampton, but in fact we ended up having many more students from other universities. The students said that when they were working on the networks in the university, they couldn't necessarily access their assistive technologies, or they didn't have time to. And what they wanted was a very simple little toolbar that would give them text-to-speech to read websites, or would change the colour, or add an overlay tint, or perhaps increase the fonts. And although it's very easy to do that in a browser, if you know how, it was actually much quicker for them just to drag this little toolbar to their particular browser, click on the particular menu item that they wanted to use, and that web page would then be read out, or the fonts would enlarge or change, or have additional line spacing, which was something that a lot of the dyslexic students talked about. The toolbar was made in a very simple way. It's actually just a piece of JavaScript, but it is added as a bookmark. So any bookmark that you might use in Firefox or Google, Chrome, or Internet Explorer, no student is downloading anything, so there's no problem with an .exe file, which is what you might have. And that's what makes it so easy. It is just like a bookmark. If you're a developer, you can actually add the code to a web page so that the ATbar sits within that web page, and then the user just clicks on it and it launches itself above the web page. There's also a way of downloading it and installing it if you want to on a server so that it can run across all the web pages of a university's website or a college's website. And we have several colleges and universities running it that way. And that makes it even easier for the user because then it appears on all the websites under, say, accessibility tools. You select that little menu item and then up pops the toolbar. We have 6 million users, and we know that Bedford College and several other colleges and our own university have been using it. There are several sites that it has been used on quite a lot, for instance, directgov.uk.